Yo, what's poppin', everybody? Welcome to the Drown My Feelings Lyric Breakdown. Doing this to commemorate a million streams on Spotify, which is wild. This is just that song of mine from the Watching Me era that just happened to, you know, just skyrocket and became kind of like an underground hit. And, you know, a lot of people are still bumping it on the daily. So I'm super grateful. It just resonates and people, you know, really feel the song and everything behind it. But yeah, I'm gonna get into it because I actually haven't, you know, really broke it down for as long as it's been out. It's been out for a long time now. Shoutouts to Shiloh Dynasty. We had sampled the vocals from that little snippet.
Can't sell right from wrong, can't right my wrongs, so I write these songs. Since that night I ain't felt the same. Do you got anything to help the pain? Do I gotta pop antidepressants? How many times till I learn my lesson? I hate going through my adolescence and I can't figure out why the hell I'm stressing.
Basically, that's just talking about, I wrote this in a very, you know, rough period of my life. I was, you know, going through a lot. I was super depressed. I had just, you know, I was like on and off with this one chick a while back. That's kind of just, it's also who I talk about on the Breakdowns and Breakthroughs EP as well. And yeah, that's basically kind of what inspired the song and where it rooted from. But yeah, that's just what I'm touching on in the beginning. Just kind of, it's just like when you're in your bed and just overthinking a lot and just staring at your ceiling and just, you know, contemplating a lot of stuff and, you know, just wondering how things are going to play out, what needs to be done, etc.
I lay awake staring at the ceiling, want to stay awake, trying to dry my feelings, can't think straight. I smile, but you know it's fake. And time to time, you come to mind. Everybody needs a ride or die. Some saying that they'd rather die. Keep thinking about what we could have had, what we should have had, but you ruined that.
It's just talking about, you know, once again, much love to her. We're cool now. There's no issues or anything like that. Yeah, you know, it's just in reference to her, of course, and just still stemming on that, just being in my feelings as I'm staring at the ceiling type, you know, just that thought of it. That just went behind the song. It's basically, like I said, it's where it stems from.
Thought it was real when you said you love me. I should have known that something was funny. Drug in my system, you corrupt me. We so unlucky. Feeling like I should just stay shut. Then you hit me up trying to make up. She's saying she don't want to lose me again, but I don't want to lose myself again.
A lot of people, you know, they'll tell you they love you. And it sucks because you never know who really means it. A lot of people can tell you they love you, just like they can say like, I love your music, or I love this, I love that. And they just throw around the word love. And also people be throwing around the word family a lot, like, yo, that's my brother, like, that's family or whatever, without, you know, really having that bond. And me being that dude who just craved, you know, companionship and that kind of stuff, when she was telling me like, yeah, I love you and all this stuff, I was so, even though we weren't really that deeply connected together, I believed it because I didn't know any better at the time. I hadn't really, you know, thought about these things. I was just on a high. It was like an emotional high. I'm like, all right, cool. Like, you know, there's somebody who appreciates me. Like, there's this chick who appreciates me, whatever. Like, it's a good feeling, you know? At the end of the day, it's just a feeling that I feel like I loved, and I didn't necessarily, you know, just love her. But once again, like, all due respect, like, much love to her. We're cool now. We're friends. And I just talk about how it's like a drug in my system corrupting me, because as much as there's a lot of benefits to having relationships and things like that, there's also a lot of, you know, pitfalls and negatives that come with it as well. It's like a, that's what keeps it balanced, because not everything, you know, is all, you know, rainbows and having a skip in your step and everything. That's just not how this works. That's basically what it is. The song was very short. I just wanted to keep it short and sweet. It's pretty crazy to think, because originally I had done the song or written it. It almost didn't even make it on the album, on the mixtape, the Watching Me mixtape. So it's like, I kind of think, but my manager TJ, shouts to him, we made the call together and be like, nah, like, this should be on it. And, you know, who knows? Like, it's kind of weird to think, like, what if this song wasn't put out, you know? Then it wouldn't have gotten the ball rolling for, you know, so many of our other songs and just Spotify and Apple and just viewership and subscribers and all this stuff, because that's really what got the ball rolling and then kind of helped gain eyes on me and whatever, just in the underground scene anyway. It's not anything mainstream, but, you know, it's a good, like, just, it's great for right now, you know? And I'm super grateful for it. I don't really know the words to formulate it and stuff, but, you know, I'll touch on that more for sure. Me and the homies, whatever, we're gonna celebrate it, and we'll have like a post about it, whatever, coming out. But yeah, once again, shouts to everybody that watched the lyric breakdown. This was the Drown My Feelings lyric breakdown. Thank you guys for streaming it. Thank you guys for streaming all the other music. More content, more music, more everything on the way. 905's finest, the gang. Subscribe, leave a like. Let's get it.
I'm good.